बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर टीचर सादिया कवर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच। स्पीच मीन्स टू टॉक। व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग विद समवन, वी आर डिवाइडेड आवर वर्ड्स, आवर टॉक्स इन अ डिफरेंट वेज, इन अ डिफरेंट पार्ट्स। दिस इज कॉल्ड पार्ट्स ऑफ स्पीच। Okay, dear students, when you start your work in your copy, first of all you will draw the margin lines, proper margin lines, and then you will make a block and you will ready a title page related to parts of speech. Dear students, as I told you that we have a topic parts of speech, and the first part of speech is noun. So our main concern is noun. Noun is a naming word. Whenever we are talking about noun, noun means it is a naming word. In the world, everything have a name. Everything have a name. Every person have a name. Every country, every city have a name. Like earth, it's a name. So this is noun. Like sky, moon, sun, these all are nouns, but we categorize these nouns in different types. There are 8 types of noun: common noun, proper noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, concrete noun, abstract noun, compound noun, and collective noun. So first we have to know about the noun, that what is noun. Noun is a naming word. It's a simple definition of noun. It's a naming word. Or we can say it is a word that represents a person, place, thing, or idea. Like any person have a name, like you, your name is Ali, Arif, Akmal, whatever you have name. Place, we are living in somewhere. We are living in some city, that is Peshawar. Peshawar is a naming word, it is a noun. We are living in Pakistan. Pakistan is a noun, it is a place. Anything, like you are wearing a shirt, shirt is a noun because it comes in the things category. Like you are sitting on a sofa, or you are sitting on a chair, or you are sitting on a floor. Floor, chair, these are nouns. Or any idea, this is called noun. Okay, one more definition. Noun is a name of person, place, thing, or idea. So these are very easy definitions of noun. Noun is a naming word. Everything have a name in the world. So this is a noun. Okay, let's move to the examples. Ali is a good boy. In this sentence, there are two nouns. One is highlighted by me. The other you will find yourself. Ali is a noun. So what is the other noun in this sentence? Okay, I love Pakistan. Pakistan is a name of a place. I like your shirt. Shirt is a name of a thing. So these are noun. Hope you understand the definition of noun. Okay, dear students, as I told you that there are 8 types of nouns, and our main topic is countable noun and uncountable noun. Countable nouns are those nouns which can be counted easily. As it shows its name itself, that counted, we can count easily, it is called countable noun. For example, I bought 5 apples. Apple is a countable noun because we can count it easily. I have 6 apples, I have 10 apples, I have 20 apples, even I have 100 apples. Ali has 6 pencils. It also shows the number of the pencils. So pencil is a countable noun. It can be count easily. Okay, the third is, she gave me oranges. Oranges is also a countable noun. Although The number of oranges are not mentioned here, but orange is a countable noun. It can be counted easily. Dear students, I make some pictures related to countable nouns like eggs. Eggs can be counted easily. Burger. We can easily count burgers even in the shop, even at home if we order. Apple can be counted easily. Watermelon, it can be also counted easily. So these are countable nouns and it can be counted easily. Okay, once more we are going to the definition. Countable nouns are those nouns which can be countable easily, which can be counted easily. Dear students, the next topic is uncountable noun. Uncountable noun is the opposite of countable noun. Easily we can say that the things which can be, which cannot be counted easily is called uncountable noun. Which cannot be counted, these are called uncounted nouns. Like your hairs, it cannot be counted. Like stars in the sky, it cannot be counted. We can't able to count the stars. We are not able to count the hairs. So these are uncountable nouns. Let's read the definition. Uncountable nouns are those nouns which cannot be counted. These are uncountable nouns. I have few examples of uncountable nouns. I like to listen music. Music is also a noun, but it is uncountable. We cannot count the music. He drinks a glass of water. Water, we cannot able, we are not able to count the drops of the water. But water is a noun, so it is uncountable. I don't like to eat rice. It is not easy to count the rice. So these are uncountable nouns. Dear students, there are some images, there are some pictures related to uncountable nouns. Like honey. Honey is a noun, but it is come in the category of uncountable noun. It is not possible that we are going to count the drops of the honey. Tea, milk, sugar. So these all are uncountable nouns. Okay, dear students. Now you will draw margin lines, proper margin lines in your neat copies, and you will write the definition of noun. You will write the examples. You will write the definition of countable noun with examples, and you will write the definition of uncountable nouns with examples. First of all, you will make a title page of parts of speech. Then you will write these three definitions with examples. After that, you have a homework, and you will do yourself in your neat copies. You will do what? You will do the underline countable nouns and uncountable nouns. You will write countable nouns on the top of the noun and you will underline as well. Like, I bought a book. Now you will mention then it is a countable noun or uncountable noun. You also underline this and you will also mention countable noun on it. I want some milk. Bring me a cup of soup. Ali has four pencils. He has a car. So dear students, this is your homework. You will do at home and you will do these things in your neat copy. Hope this lecture will help you to do your work in your home, at your home, and you will learn these things easily at home. Good luck. Allah Hafiz.